So I wrote to Hermann Zapf, who's by then a good friend, and I said, Hermann, I've got this idea for a crazy book called 316. Can you do the cover for me? The cover, I want you to make the most beautiful three that's ever been designed in the history of the world. And the most beautiful colon, the most beautiful one, the most beautiful six. And then I can have my book and it'll look, you know, it'll look great, saying 316. So Hermann wrote back enthusiastically saying, you know, and he'd also taken a couple of the verses of the Bible that he'd found in his German Bible. And he did it with his calligraphy, and he's one of the greatest calligraphers of all time. And then he said, you know, Don, I know hundreds of calligraphers around the world. I could get those people to contribute a page to your book, and each one could do these verses. Well, you know, as I said, graphic designers turn out to be the nicest people in the world, and he was going to introduce me to even more of them this way. While I'm in Boston and cleaning house and things like this, I also go to the Boston Public Library and to the Christian Science Bible Museum and Harvard, Andover-Harvard Theological Library and study and copy down all the different translations of these verses that I can find and read as many, you know, start reading the commentaries on the verses so that I can really research the subject much better than I had done cursorily in the 70s. Hermann made calligraphy for the verse John 3:16, which is the one that the reason we chose 3:16. It's the most famous verse in the Bible by its number. People in the Super Bowl always hold up signs saying John 3:16, and it's sort of a capsule review of the gospel. And I chose Hermann to be the calligrapher for that verse, and he provided me with a sample page showing his rendition of John 3:16. So while I'm in Boston, I got the sample page printed at a good printer, and then Hermann and I drafted a letter to these 60 calligraphers around the world, the best in their respective countries, inviting them to contribute their pages for the other verse. So this was a project that I had time to do while I was in Boston, And I spent a lot of time then in the Boston Public Library and these other libraries reading what people's comments were on these verses that I by the time the end of my sabbatical, the end of Jill's sabbatical occurred, which I was in the middle of the Old Testament. Let me think. I was just getting into Song of Solomon at that time, and then we drove across country to get back to California, and I stopped off in Yale for a couple of days to use the Divinity School library there and did the Book of Isaiah and Jeremiah. And I stopped off in Pennsylvania, you know, Pittsburgh Theological Seminary. It's different places coming across country, working on this. And then got back to Stanford, and I still had a few more years to go through the New Testament. And we got great libraries out here, Stanford Library, Berkeley, Graduate Theological Union Library. And so it's a weekend project for several more years after that to see what the story of these 316s would be.